I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime.
So here's a little film that I've just made about my project to build this hut, this wagon, for £500. This film is just a brief introduction to the project, what I'm actually trying to achieve, and how I'm going about it. And it's the first of a number of films. So after that, it's going to be a whole series of films going right back to basics, nuts and bolts, showing you how to build it. My name's Tom, and I'm building this hut completely out of pallets. And you can actually see the pallets here that it's built out of. 1, 2, 3, 4. But if you have a look at the other end, you'll see
that when it's finished, hopefully, no one will guess.
There we are. And let's have a little look outside. So from the outside, you would not guess, I think, that it's built out of pallets at all. And let's just have a quick look at the planks.
You'll see here that I've got these lovely kind of single length planks, so it's not like a kind of herringbone patchwork of pallet planks.
So those nice unbroken planks, they're not strictly pallets, but it's actually this stuff. And here we are, I'll show you.
That is proper 4x1, all for nothing. This is actually the packing crates that shop blinds come in. So there's a shop blind supplier, and the roller blind mechanism comes in these big beautiful long crates all kind of bolted together, so you have to break it to pieces. But you get kind of 12 foot lengths of this stuff. Now my main motivation for going down this route was budget. I mean, I've wanted a shepherd's hut for a long time. Obviously can't afford one, £20,000 upwards or whatever, and I thought I could build one myself. But then when I worked it out, I actually budgeted it would be at least £3,000 just to even build one myself. And worst of all, the wheels. And you'll know that if you don't want, you know, cricket screen or chicken shed wheels on your hut, you're going to lose a couple of thousand quid just on a nice set of wheels. So you need the money up front. So I was kind of scratching my head, and kind of my project wasn't getting underway. And then I realized that the wheels off one of these, you can pick them up anywhere for about a fiver. To be honest, I've been interested in the idea of road wheels on the thing for a little while. More thinking along the lines of a living van, the things they used to tow behind traction engines, more than a kind of pure shepherd's hut. And that is really because, to my eye, a real shepherd's hut is actually quite a narrow, skinny, dainty little thing, and you certainly can't fit a double bed and a kind of garden studio inside it. So I actually prefer the living van, the proportions of it. It's a kind of, you can build something useful that's kind of more true to the original sort of style and character of the thing. And that's when I had the revelation, Land Rover wheels. So I've got a set of wheels to start for absolutely nothing, and bang, I'm on my way. And that's when I realised pallets are the answer. I mean, I'll be honest, I've been slightly obsessed with pallets kind of my whole life. You see them around and you think, I'm sure you could do something good with these. And I've built the odd thing, you know, kind of compost bins and bits of furniture. You know, we all mess around with them. But you think, wouldn't it be great to build something really spectacular just entirely from the pallets and this marvellous packing material? This is really nice. It actually says Wareham on it there. That's actually the destination from when it actually was a kind of delivery crate. So I've saved this plank. I'm going to use it somewhere in the hut. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do, but I really like that. But yeah, nearly forgot that one of my favourite things about the whole thing is that the chassis, the whole kind of the basis of the wagon, is actually one giant pallet. It's just amazing. The timber is 2 inches, the planks on the top are full 2 inches by 8 inches. Big, beautiful planks. I mean, the pallet itself must have been hundreds of pounds to make. And actually, a biomass boiler came on it. So when you look around, these big pieces of kit that go into building projects, if the piece of kit is expensive, it will be sitting on a beautiful, expensive pallet. Not rubbish at all. Really nice quality timber. And it just had to be disposed of. They were pleased for me to take it away. So that is the basis. And then 6 pallets, regular pallets on top of that. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2 high, 3 long, So the actual construction itself, it is literally pallets all stuck together with the kind of packing crate materials on the outside. A proper pallet wagon. Also, just to mention things like this lovely window, it's a kind of old 1920s crittle window that is from someone's refurb project that was actually on their outdoor loo. So that's really beautifully made, but also the shape of it. Because even when you build something out of rubbish, you want the proportions to be nice. Oh, and another thing we want to look at is these lovely big structural bits of timber. Have a look at this. So here, this is my working steering turntable. So it actually turns. I haven't got the A-frame on the front. You're going to make up a kind of iron A-frame. But these are fabulous. You can see really nice sections of wood. And they come from steel suppliers. So these big bulks of timber are what RSJs come on. So if you go to any steel stockholder, the big sections of steel will have long lengths of these. Again, sometimes 10 feet long of this kind of 4-inch square timber with the bits of steel. I mean, it's fabulous. You could literally build a whole proper house out of that stuff. So it's actually been a lot of fun kind of utilizing all of those materials. And the other great thing with the wheels and the planks is this entire hut is kind of recycled, repurposed materials. So you really could say it's a kind of zero carbon as well as a zero budget build. And in terms of budget, the whole thing I've managed to do for 500 quid, all in. So that's my hut.
Okay, so you've seen the intro film to kind of what this is all about, how I'm going about building it, what I'm trying to achieve. And what I'm going to do now is a series of episodes going right back to the beginning, kind of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, showing how I've actually built it in a bit more detail, all of the bits and pieces. Because I know people watch these kinds of films for all sorts of different reasons. And I'm kind of making this film with a view, well, partly just for myself, because, you know, this is quite a thing. It's taken me a little while and I wanted to record it just kind of as I went on, for myself, so I could see what I'd done. But also with a view that if anyone else is watching and actually wants to build something like this, so you'll see that that's the kind of angle I've taken. You literally could follow the films, get your cordless drill, your screwdriver, your saw, and you could put something together very like this. And the other thing I'm going to be doing to kind of go along with that is I'm actually going to be coming up with a book, because I've been, you know, what have we got here? I've been taking notes and doing drawings and sketches. I don't know how well you can see that here. That's the kind of detail of how the roof and the plank structure kind of goes together. And I've got there some designs for the inside, and over the page here, what have we got there? Some of the initial sketches. That's how the kind of front turntable steering mechanism all kind of goes together. So yeah, lots of actual dimensions. There's a kind of plan of the interior and how the pallets all fit together. So yeah, copious drawings, information, actual, my own measurements on there for how it all goes together. And as well as that, obviously I've got loads of kind of receipts, invoices for all of the bits and bobs, because I wanted to know exactly how much it's cost, because the whole thing right from the outset was to do this on a budget. Now, it says 500 quid. That is my target budget. I think I have definitely run over the 500. I haven't done a full tot up, but I've been kind of keeping tallies. I reckon, though, I would say I'm still within £1,000. So this beautiful, I mean, I'm really pleased with it. It's already, as I say, quite a useful little space, and looks nice sitting in the garden. And all in so far under £1,000, as I think I might have mentioned before, if you were absolutely fixed that it had to be within the budget, it could have been done much cheaper. So I've used, say, proper tongue and groove planking for the ceiling, but there is no reason whatsoever that some of the planks that I've actually procured for nothing, the free packing planks, couldn't have been used to do, you know. So basically there's a few shortcuts I've done where I have actually knowingly gone out and purchased something just partly to save time, because it has taken me a few years, but also, as I think I'll touch on as I go through, I've got all sorts of other projects going on at the same time, not least my daily driver
is a kind of coming on 70-year-old sports car, which is not in itself in particularly good condition. It's actually worse than lots of people's restoration projects. And that is what I drive every day. So that takes up an awful lot of my time. So yeah, I've made a few shortcuts to kind of push it forward where I've actually spent a little bit of money. But if I'd been willing to put in a bit more kind of time labor, pulling apart pallets, or even just waiting and sourcing that piece of material, I could have done it. So yeah, I have been writing down, and that's, as I say, what's going to go in my book. I've got all my invoices of what everything has come to. Now I touched on some other things. The book, it won't be straight away, because I know, like a lot of people who do this kind of YouTube type stuff all the time, it's quite kind of rigorous. I have to knock out a video every week, and I'm afraid I won't be able to do that because I've got my day job, I've got a family, and I've got a number of aging and decrepit automobile machines that I must keep running. But I will do it. It will come out. I have actually done it before. In fact, here we are. There's a book I did with a good friend, Trevor Evans, Ghosts of the Falklands. Check it out. It's a few years ago now. But yeah, that still pops up. You can still get that on Amazon. So it will take a little while. And the book will kind of be literally like an instruction guide for how you could build one of these, but with a little bit of kind of wider history of huts, wagons, you know, a few examples of other peoples. Because, you know, I have taken an interest in some of the different builders who are making huts and some of the original huts that are being restored. So that's all going to be in there. So over time, keep an eye open for that. If I manage to, I might even whack some of that stuff kind of on a website or somewhere, so you can actually, and there'll be links kind of on the channel popping up. But yeah, so if you kind of watch my profile, you can see me on Twitter as well, Junkyard Tom. And so yeah, that's that. So the next thing I'm gonna do is start knocking out some films, and so you can watch them just if you want to laugh at my foolish exploits or wonder what I'm getting up to. You can watch it, or you can watch it and start sharpening your saws and getting your screwdrivers out, and you can build something like this yourself. So I hope you enjoy watching. Thanks for watching so far. And see you on the way.
I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through.